SpaceX closed the lifting points of ship 28 with TPS tiles. Yes, it's time for the launch. NASA reveals updates on Crew 8 mission. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. In this episode, we will talk about the progress of Starship Flight 3, the third integrated test flight of the Starship and Super Heavy vehicles, which is expected to take place within weeks. Starship Flight 3 will be the most ambitious and challenging test flight so far, as it will attempt to reach near-orbital velocity and demonstrate the re-entry and landing capabilities of both stages. The flight will also validate the performance of the Starship's heat shield tiles, which are crucial for protecting the vehicle from the extreme temperatures and pressures of atmospheric re-entry. The vehicles for Starship Flight 3 are Ship 28 and Booster 10, which have been undergoing testing and preparation at SpaceX's Starbase facility in Boca Chica, Texas. Both vehicles have completed several tests, including cryo-proof tests, spin primes, and static fires to verify their structural integrity and engine functionality. Ship 28 is the second stage of the Starship system and is equipped with 6 Raptor engines, 3 of which are optimized for sea-level thrust and 3 for vacuum thrust. Ship 28 also features a large payload bay, a forward and aft flap system, and a nose cone. Booster 10 is the first stage of the Starship system, which is a massive reusable rocket that can lift the Starship to orbit and then return to Earth for landing and reuse. Booster 10 is powered by 33 Raptor engines, which are arranged in a hexagonal pattern with a central engine and 4 concentric rings of 8 engines each. Booster 10 also has a grid fin system that is similar to the Falcon ones. Both Ship 28 and Booster 10 have been rolled out to the launch site and mounted on the orbital launch mount, which is a massive steel structure that supports the vehicles and provides them with propellant, power, and data. The orbital launch mount also has a flame diverter plate, which deflects the exhaust plume of the engines and protects the pad from damage. The next steps for Starship Flight 3 involve finalizing some remaining work before integrated stack testing and eventually launch. This includes tiling over the lifting points, which are the locations where the vehicles are attached to the transporters and cranes. Tiling over these points is a time-consuming task, as it requires precise alignment and installation of the heat shield tiles, which are made of hexagonal ceramic tiles that can withstand temperatures of up to 1,500 degrees Celsius. SpaceX might be just weeks away from launching Starship Flight 3, but the company has not provided an update of the aftermath from the previous Starship test flight in November 2023. Also, before Starship Flight 3 can take place, the Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, must review and approve the investigation into the previous Starship flight and grant a new commercial launch license to SpaceX. The FAA is responsible for ensuring the safety and environmental compliance of commercial space launches and has been closely monitoring SpaceX's Starship program. Starship Flight 3 will be a historic and groundbreaking mission, as it will demonstrate the full potential of the Starship system, which aims to revolutionize space exploration and colonization. Starship Flight 3 will also be a key milestone for SpaceX's contract with NASA to develop a lunar version of Starship, which will land the first humans on the moon since the Apollo program. SpaceX is also preparing additional Starship vehicles for future test flights and missions, in line with the company's development approach, which emphasizes frequent testing and rapid iteration. SpaceX's founder and CEO, Elon Musk, has set ambitious goals for Starship production, stating that he wants to build 1,000 Starships in 10 years and launch 100 Starships per year to achieve his vision of colonizing Mars in 3 decades. Now, we will talk about the upcoming Crew 8 mission, which will send 4 astronauts to the International Space Station on board a SpaceX Crew Dragon spacecraft. This mission is scheduled to launch in mid-February 2024, and it will be the 9th crewed mission to the ISS by NASA and SpaceX. But before we get into the details, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any of our future videos. The Crew 8 mission is part of NASA's Commercial Crew program, which aims to provide safe, reliable, and cost-effective access to low Earth orbit for NASA and its partners. The program has contracted two private companies, SpaceX and Boeing, to develop and operate crewed spacecraft that can ferry astronauts to and from the ISS. SpaceX's Crew Dragon and Boeing Starliner are the two spacecraft that have been selected for this program. However, so far, only SpaceX has successfully completed all the required tests and certifications, and has flown 8 crewed missions to the ISS, while Boeing is still working on resolving some technical issues with its Starliner. The Crew 8 mission will be the 4th operational flight of the Crew Dragon, following the Crew 1, Crew 2, and Crew 3 missions, which launched in November 2020, April 2021, and October 2023, respectively. The Crew 8 mission will also be the first to use a new variant of the Crew Dragon called the Crew Dragon 2.0, which features some upgrades and improvements over the previous version. Some of these upgrades include a larger trunk, which is the unpressurized section of the spacecraft that carries cargo and solar panels, a redesigned heat shield, which protects the spacecraft from the extreme temperatures during re-entry, and a new docking system, which allows the spacecraft to autonomously dock and undock from the ISS. The Crew 8 mission will launch from Launch Complex 39A at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida, on top of a Falcon 9 rocket, which is also developed and operated by SpaceX. The Falcon 9 is a reusable rocket, which means that it can land back on Earth after delivering its payload to orbit and be reused for future missions. The Falcon 9 that will be used for the Crew 8 mission will be a new one, but the Crew Dragon spacecraft will be a refurbished one, which previously flew the Crew 2 mission. This will be the third time that a Crew Dragon spacecraft will be reused for a crewed mission, demonstrating SpaceX's commitment to reusability and sustainability. The Crew 8 mission will last for about 6 months, during which the astronauts will join the existing crew of the ISS and conduct various scientific experiments, maintenance tasks, and outreach activities. The Crew 8 astronauts will also witness the arrival and departure of several other spacecraft, such as the SpaceX Cargo Dragon, the Northrop Grumman Cygnus, the Russian Progress and Soyuz, and the Chinese Tianzhou and Shenzhou. One of the most exciting events that the Crew 8 astronauts will witness is the landing of the first U.S. commercial lunar lander called Peregrine, which is developed by Astrobotic, a private company that won a contract from NASA to deliver payloads to the moon. Peregrine is expected to launch from the Cape Canaveral Space Force Station on Monday, February 5th, 2024, and land on the moon on February 23rd, 2024, carrying 20 payloads, 5 of which are from NASA. This will be the first time that a U.S. commercial spacecraft will land on the moon, and the first time that a U.S. spacecraft will land on the moon since the Apollo program. The Crew 8 mission will end in late August 2024, when the Crew Dragon spacecraft will undock from the ISS and return to Earth, splashing down in the Atlantic Ocean off the coast of Florida. The Crew 8 astronauts will then be replaced by the Crew 9 astronauts, who will arrive at the ISS on board another Crew Dragon spacecraft a few days before the Crew 8 departure. The Crew 9 mission will be the 10th crewed mission to the ISS by NASA and SpaceX, and it will carry 4 astronauts, 2 from NASA, 1 from the European Space Agency, or ESA, and 1 from the Canadian Space Agency, or CSA. The Crew 8 mission is a testament to the success and innovation of the Commercial Crew Program, which has enabled NASA and its partners to resume regular crewed flights to the ISS from U.S. soil after a gap of 9 years, since the retirement of the Space Shuttle in 2011. The program has also fostered a new era of commercial spaceflight, where private companies can offer their services and capabilities to NASA and other customers for various missions in low Earth orbit and beyond. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.